covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 5.
Today, students at Lynn University remember the victims of a killer earthquake in 2010. Thanks for watching. I'm Victor Blackwell. The university dedicated a remembrance plaza this morning. Angela Rozier is covering South County in Boca Raton.
The president of Lynn University says when they built this remembrance plaza, they wanted it to be more than just a memorial. He says when people came here to visit, he wanted them to actually feel the spirit of those who lost their lives. Well, today, he got a chance to see if that happened.
I think it's absolutely breathtaking. It's gorgeous. It's exactly what they would have wanted.
Professors Patrick Hartwick and Richard Bruno, students Courtney Hayes, Christine Genicacy, Brittany Gangle, and Stephanie Crespinelli will forever be a part of Lynn University. The Remembrance Plaza sits next to the Student Center. It has a waterfall cascading from the roof, and there are six prisms with a name and a description of the students or professors written by their families.
It's been a long and very difficult road, and you know, continues to be, but we wanted to make sure that we remember the best of those who we lost, and we believe that this memorial does that.
The six died during an earthquake in Haiti on January 12, 2010. The university president says this remembrance plaza was designed to forever honor their legacies and showcase their spirit of service.
I think she would have said, this is fabulous.
Lynn Gangle says his daughter, Brittany, loved helping others. He and his wife are building an orphanage in Haiti in her honor.
And I had spoken to her on the Monday and Tuesday of the, the Tuesday of the earthquake, but just 3 hours before, I got the text that said they love us so much, yet they have nothing. They're all so appreciative. I want to move here and start an orphanage myself, and I still have that on my cell phone.
Hundreds showed up at the Boca Raton campus Friday morning to take part in the unveiling ceremony. The Gangle family says they feel blessed and hope no one will forget.
You know, it's heartbreaking to go through this and what we went through, but we're honoring her at Be Like Brit, and we're keeping her spirit alive, and we're helping the children of Haiti, which was her last wish.
About 600 donors made gifts toward this project. Officials say the total cost is about $1.7 million. But coming up at 6, I will introduce you to a woman who says if it weren't for their sacrifices, she wouldn't be here today. In Boca Raton, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.